What herbicides do you recommend around fruit trees? And this is from Kevin. It's YouTube. Mr. D knows all about using those herbicides around fruit trees.
Yeah.
What say you, Mr. D?
Yeah, and you got to be kind of careful. I know commercial guys can get away with using some herbicides that homeowners can't use.
Right.
And Gramoxone is an example. It's a restricted use pesticide, and homeowners can't use it. A non-selective product that is probably why they use it out there. But for homeowners, grass materials, probably post.
Post is the first thing I thought.
Was that Sethoxydim?
Uh-huh.
That's the trade name. And that you might need to remember the Sethoxydim more than post, because post is just one trade name of that product. But it's just a grass material. For broadleaf, Glyphosate is labeled, and you can use it. Be very careful with glyphosate products around fruit trees. If you get any drift, it can make some of the trees do some weird things. Mm-hmm. I've seen them get abnormal growths on the bark and especially grapes, muscadine type grapes do weird things around Roundup. So be very careful. What else do you know of any other broadleaf materials that would work for you?
Not for the homeowner.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you can use some of those other things that are out there, like, you know, the weed begones, but you have to be careful and read the label on that.
Right. And some of those you would only need to use real early.
Yes.
You know, in the spring.
Right.
Before the trees begin to bud.
Because, of course, they contain, you know, the 2,4-D, the dicamba, you know, is in there as well, which will control broadleaf weeds,
right.
Not grasses, though.
Not the grasses.
Right.
You know, I don't know if quinclerac is an active in weed,
right.
One of the weed
for crabgrass control,
and I don't know whether it does control some of the other grasses, perennial foxtail and things like that, and I just don't know whether or not it's a label for fruit trees
yet. You have to read the label on that, because I wouldn't know that right offhand.
The one thing we do know is labeled for fruit trees. It's very safe as a hoe. And don't dig too deep, right. Because feeder roots tend to be very shallow. But I mean, you can take a hoe and just very shallowly, you know, keep, you know, and it's, if you can keep it weed free all the way out to the drip line,
wow.
That would be a great thing to do, because the fruit tree doesn't need that competition between grass. And, you know, I don't like to see grass going right up to the bark or to the base of a tree. Mulching.
That's what I'm going to ask you about that. What do you think about mulching?
It's not really recommended for fruit trees. However, a light mulch probably won't hurt you at all. But a light
couple
mulch
inches.
Isn't going to do very much for weed control problems.
Yeah.
You know, you could probably get away with maybe some landscape.
The fabric?
Fabric. You know, you might even, because... And you would probably want to move that out, pull that out in the wintertime, because those fruit trees are, especially in the late winter, are going to need that ground heat.
Right.
They're going to need the ground heat to be able to be released and come up and help protect them.
Hope you enjoyed the video. We would love to get more questions from you. So be sure to leave us some comments.